And talking about Thainess, what do you like or what's coming up into your mind when talking about Thainess, especially if we would like to explain the strength of Thai culture to international community? What would be it in terms of our description? Today we have Khun Tharit Charungvat, Secretary General of Thailand Foundation, who has been doing very Herculean job in explaining Thailand to the world, and he's joining us right now in the studio. Swadee kha, thank you very much for joining
thank
us.
Thank you for joining us. Just a minute ago, we were talking about hard power, the clashes between two major powers, India and China, right? Okay, let's leave that behind. We are moving to soft power now, Gunatha.
Yes, but with Thailand Foundation, probably people do not quite know what it is about and what is it doing. Can you just explain a bit?
Thank you for having me tonight. You mentioned about Thailand Foundation, of which I'm now Secretary General. I assumed this duty from December last year, the same time of the occurrence of COVID-19, if you like. Thailand Foundation has been there for more than a decade, but it has been more active only about 4 years ago. Before me was Khun Sarot Chawanawilat, former foreign minister and permanent secretary. And I assumed this duty after him. Thailand Foundation is not quite known because we have some management or budgetary concern. Which is no one to be blamed.
Okay. That's a common problem for all Thai agencies.
And seems to be another challenge after COVID, because we have to disburse money to other sector, which is agreeable, understandable. Thailand Foundation is, if I start with comparison with other country, for British, you have British Council. French, France, you have Alliance Française, Curte of German. China now have Confucius Institute. Japan has Japan Foundation. Korea have Korean Foundation. And this sort of thing is known in international fora, but not as much to the Thai public. What we are doing, Thailand Foundation is the extended arm of Ministry of Foreign Affairs. We are doing public diplomacy. Let me explain the public diplomacy. Public diplomacy, if you like, is the supplement or complement to conventional or traditional diplomacy. Diplomacy that we know is more or less governmental to governmental or high-level official conduct of foreign policy. But as time goes by, world has turned to a more democratic system, which also means that government will have to listen to public more. That is why public diplomacy become more and more important. It means that this instrument or organization will focus on public of other country in order to put it, the easiest way is to increase our fan club.
Am I correct to say that this is an instrument for projection of Thai soft power?
You can put it that way. Soft power and, well, in fact, I don't like the word power at all, because if it is soft, you need to be soft, so to speak. Okay. Now, this is what we are doing. We are doing diplomacy to the target in other country at people level. In the past, traditional diplomacy, they also attend to this matter, but it is a softer side if you work it on a foundation basis, just like many other country is doing. Then How do we do it?
Okay.
You mentioned about Thainess.
Mm. Yes.
You mentioned about soft power. Soft power, if you like this term, in many countries they have different soft power. Swedish has their own soft power, of which they don't have what we have. Mm. Japan does have, India does have, but the strength, the strong point of this kind of soft power of Thailand is the so-called Thainess. Mm. What does it mean, Thainess in my sense? Among ambassadors who works as my colleague, the Thai ambassador throughout, we have been discussing or do assessment of what is the strength of Thailand. How come there are so many million of people increasingly visited Thailand each year? We are mentioning before COVID.
Yeah.
After all, the strength is the Thai people. Mm. It's the Thai people. Of course, tourism authority is doing very well. Ministry of Culture is doing extremely well in order to project culture, our heritage, our sun, sea, sand, if you like. That is also our strength. But look into the number of visitors. Then quite high percentage that they come over and over again and again.
Yeah, yeah.
If they visit a place, I don't think they come back to visit that same place in general terms. But they visit us according to our assessment because they like Thai people.
And that, does it mean that Thailand Foundation would have to promote Thai people to international community?
We have, exactly, we have to enshrine what is the property in our human capital, the Thai people. When foreigners visited Thailand, they feel that they are free. They are big guy. They are well respected. Racism is a non-issue in this country. In terms, if you put it in a word, we offer respect to whatever you are, you know, poor, rich, whatever. You are our guest.
Yeah, yeah.
This is one term that I like to explain. Respect is one of the key terms. The other, which is also equally important, is compassion. Compassion, mindfulness, kindness, benevolence, whatever you like, is embedded in our people. So this is also the gesture, knowing that or not, is the exposure of Thai people to foreigner.
But how do you go about promoting these Thai characteristics? Say if you go to a country A, right, and your job is to make people in this country know about Thailand, Thainess, Thai characters. In practical term, how do you do it?
It's not easy, and it's a long-term process. Yeah. We are trying to do it by projecting the spirit values of our culture, our heritage, even Muay Thai, which is a martial art. We have properties, spiritual property in it. This is the best way to explain it. It's by the Thai people itself. Ourself, we explain it by our natural act.
By our way of life.
By our way of life.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But we are trying to make that wider and deeper. This is how public diplomacy is trying to enlarge our footprint in targeted countries. This is varies to the budget that we have.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
In many countries, you have billion of US dollar in your pocket.
We don't have that much money. No, many countries do it by having movies, exhibitions, cultural events, forums, seminar. But so, what about
this?
Your
This is also our instrument.
Okay.
You know, during my period of time, we have a little problem of COVID. That we cannot reach out. Mm. But in our work plan, these are something that we try to project more to the world, of course, in cooperation with Ministry of Culture, Tourism Authority of Thailand, and many other agencies. Also, those producers of movie, of series, you know, even Muay Thai camp.
Okay. Yeah.
Let me cite an example if we have time. As ambassador, when I posted in South Africa, I went to a Muay Thai camp to visit them on my routine. Mm-hmm. And come one day, a native South African fellow walked to me, and he talked to me, looking into my eyes, that ambassador, I'm so grateful of Muay Thai. My son asked me whether I can attend Muay Thai. He said Muay Thai has changed his son after attending Muay Thai camp. Changed him to turn him into a very disciplined child. Know how to respect people and become more responsible in comparison to prior attending this course. Well, that enlightened me tremendously. That is not only martial art, defensive way of boxing or whatever, but it has taught this fellow, which I believe that this is also true in many cases. So we need to make this spirit of property of many other Thais cultural heritage to surface to the world. Allow me to go further into what we are doing under the Thai Foundation. That is the general aspect of what we are trying to project Thailand in a deeper sense. But on the other side, we do exchange program as well under the umbrella of Thai studies. This is what we are trying to engage people, target people, university, to learn more Thai, to research about Thailand on whatever aspect that they want, so that they can convey as ambassador, if you like, of all this knowledge to the world. We also offer Thai learning, Thai language learning as well, so that people at least know some Thai and come to Thailand, they can interact with people.
So that many aspects of the culture, Thai culture and Thai character that you'd like to export to other countries and to make other countries really appreciate Thainess, like compassion, respect, and
openness.
And but what do you like to do more among Thai people in Thailand as well? Because probably you appreciate, because you work in international community and you look back and you appreciate this Thainess in Thai people, among Thai people. But what if Thai people are not very much aware of it? Do you have to do something more among Thai people as well?
This is very challenging. I believe that not much of a Thai people knows about this property of theirs. We take it for granted.
That's right.
We take it for granted. Mm. The value in our family, in our household, religious circle, whatever in society. For example, the way we greet people, which become fashionable, which is valuable these days.
Yeah.
Tell me the country, the language of countries, which has a suffix of each sentence with ka and krap. There are a few, but this is our property. And I'm saying that it's a challenge of how to tell Thai people.
That's right.
Of how to make Thai people value and keep this with them as the pace of the society is too rush. This is not my responsibility.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. But because of the importance of this, I think I will remind authority concerned as much as I can, that we have to revert back to our value as much as possible.
As you mentioned, you have issue with limited resources, right? You can't do this in every country in the world. So what are specific countries or groups of countries that you are paying a special attention to promote the Thai diplomacy?
Talk about resource. I have to work in collaboration with other agencies as well. Between us, they have budget that I can work hand in hand with them. In particular, the Thai International Development Agency under the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, the Department of Information, and so on and so forth. We have a good member of board whereby PTT, ThaiBev, CP is also a member, Midpoint, and so on and so forth. These are beneficiaries somehow because they have their footprint around the world that public diplomacy by Thailand Foundation will help them to do the CSR in their vicinity. But you are right to mention that with limited resource, what are the priorities? My priority is the neighboring countries. Neighboring countries is what we have to attend to, not in my term, but in our foreign policy that is announced, that was announced to the parliament. Neighboring country is our prime, client. Because if you once you share border, once you share the border with them, a lot of things can happen, positively or negatively. Misunderstood can happen. But if we have that people to understand who we are, what is in the depth of our thinking, this can help in the case of crisis, can alleviate, mobility in a negative form, because this can hold them to have a second thought, if I may.
Yeah. So are you saying that there's still a gap in understanding among our neighbors toward Thailand in that sense?
Well, understanding is a never-ending kind of activities. You have new generations and so on and so forth. New media come to their brain and eyes and interpretation. Misunderstanding remain. Clear up all the misunderstanding. What we are trying to do is to put the real story, as immunity into people around us. Because this is the most, sensitive.
To make them see the big picture, to understand
picture.
As a whole.
Make into a big
not to be influenced by just single isolated exactly. incidents, right?
Exactly, exactly, which has been, which was happened before.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
You know. So in the near future, we will see the work by Thailand Foundation on media, on exhibition in international arena soon in order to promote?
Soon, how soon, I don't know, because of the, you know, situation of the world. Uh-huh. But for me, having an office like Institute of other country, as I mentioned, is not my target in the near or mid-term future. Because these days, I think we need to use more of the media mm-hmm. and social media.
Yes.
Because it's going to your palm. Mm. You don't have to go to any institution right, yeah. in the heart of Bangkok with traffic and so on and so forth. Mm. Let's put this content into their phone.
Right there in their hands, yeah.
In their hands. Mm. Make them among the priority that they will swipe into. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So this is what we are trying to tune to what is fashionable these days.
But is the COVID-19 pandemic making you to rethink about your strategy or your plans?
Not really. We only need to remind what we are good at. Okay. What property do we have?
We are good at in public health system. And that's why we has been a success story that being cited by many countries in the world.
Well, I cannot agree more with you. COVID-19 somehow is a blessing in disguise because it made known to the world of our public health system, of the welfare system on this, the in the public health, of the administration of handling of COVID, which is another sector of public health, you know, our that's personnel right. and so on and so forth. Our record speak louder. Yeah. With that, I think the spotlight has turned somehow, somewhat to Thailand that, hey, this is the country
that's right.
that relatively safe, so to speak.
A very yeah. positive spotlight.
And if by that means, if we highlight or remind them of what we were, where we were before COVID, this will be complementary to each other. Mm. That's this in my projection to see how much can we go.
Yeah.
Okay, so probably we will see more work to be done after COVID-19, and that could be opportunity to promote Thailand in international community.